Yes guys, I hope you're all well and welcome back to another video. In this video we have the Audi UK Press S3 Sportback in Tango Red. I've had it for quite a while now, so I thought I'd make a video on the things I like and dislike about the car. But yeah, let's get straight into this video. So I don't know whether I'm showing my age and whether I'm... sorry about that. Whether I'm into the more simplistic things in life, hence why I'm probably only about 3 pairs of trainers. But you all right, mate? Yeah? Oh, lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. You're not having any fuel shortage, are you? Hey, your little green license plate. Yeah, there's no actual physical scroll when it comes to volume. So on the steering wheel again, you've got the normal one, you can just roll around here. But I've always liked to just be able to ease it. Now I'm going to say something that I need a lot of you to be very mature about. Come on then, why buy the car if you can't fit, mate? Yeah, there's no knob, and for me, whenever it comes to volume, I like just grabbing that knob and just giving it a twist and just be like, yeah, I can control this knob. Easy. When it comes to volume, you've got this touch sensitive little swiggle thing, which can be a bit distracting depending on your frame of mind and your mentality. But yeah, there is no physical volume button that you can literally turn as a knob. You've got this thing down here, and unless you're with it and you went through the tutorial when you bought the car, you might not notice that you actually have a volume button down there that you can kind of touch sensitive. And it's just not something that appeals to me. I like, again, like I said, having that physical knob just to grab and just give it a little twist. Something else I noticed, a lot of the newer brands are doing it, is when you go through the drive select modes and you select anything north of a comfort setting, you tend to get a little different like cockpit view, but nothing happens in the cockpit. Sure, it tells you what drive select you are in the left part of the cockpit, but there's no red, and I know it's like more of a gimmick, like more of a kid's toy sort of thing, but I like knowing straight away when I click that button, everything's gonna go red and I'm in dynamic. Like, well, I don't know why they didn't do that. You look at a lot of the other cars, maybe because it's an S and not an R, but I would have thought with an S, you kind of should get a few of the toys, and that's a toy that they could easily have just coded in. So something else, this side mirror placement is very unnatural to me. It feels like it's very in my face, and I've got, in my opinion, a good enough driving position where I'm in control of the car, can kind of see where I'm going, which is great, and I'm seated in the lowest position. Maybe it's because these are the electric seats, so obviously I'm not going to get the best position, but I feel like these side mirrors could do with just going, I don't know, whether it's, I don't know, 15 centimeters forward, because it just feels very in my face, and I've constantly had to adjust them while I'm out driving, and that's something that you kind of want to do once and just like fit and forget, if that makes any sense. Now let's talk about the positives, because there is a lot of positives with this car. Starting with the interior design, which is great to begin with. This rear view mirror is beautiful, and I mean that. It's edgeless, which means it hasn't got any cheap plastic surrounding it or anything like that. It just looks like glass. It looks like somebody's just got a nice piece of glass, they've chiseled it, they've shaded it, they've filed it down to perfection, and they've said, hi sir, you can have this lovely auto glass mirror in your car for free. It's like, it's beautiful. Like, this is going to sound really stupid, but it's the small things like this that really make an interior feel like prestige. And as we were touching on the interior, the center console in here, I think everybody that's had a sit in this car and had a look at it, straight away they're like, wow, center console. Center console looks generations ahead. Totally generated. And remember, this is the S3. This is bar the A1, the S, I don't know if there's an S1, but this is like the entry level when it comes into the Audi range. Then you've got the A4, the A5, etc. This is an S3, and look at the interior. You've got these nice, you've got Quattro logo there, you've got good texture material, not cheap. It's got, I don't know what the word is, but it's got some feel to it, the dashboard, but more importantly, center console wise, apart from that little knob there, that little feeling or tactic feedback volume button there, the screen is different level. It's like 8K screen. It's like JVC screen. It's slapped it in there. It's really crisp, really clear. Other thing I would mention is that the piano black, I don't know whether this can be specced, but it's been cleaned recently. Part of them dropping a car off, it's going to be sanitized and whatnot. And if I clean it again and again, I know it's going to scratch, so it's something that I haven't wanted to do. I've got a bit of dust on there, but if I clean it, it's going to scratch. Maybe you can go down the road of PPF, but that's the only thing, is just the piano black. If you do get kids with fingerprints and McDonald's fingers, not McDonald's fingers, McDonald's on their fingers, then you're going to, can you imagine if a kid had McDonald's fingers? Hey, daddy, eating their fingers. But piano black isn't my cup of tea when it comes to interior, simply because it's something you're gonna have to stay on top of, and I'd rather not. In short, I don't mind cleaning the outside of the car, but not the inside. I'm not too bad. I've got bad back, can't really move and get into these positions. While we're on the subject of interior, armrest is a big thing for me. I threw something back the other day to my mate saying, this car is the only car I've been in that's got an adjustable armrest. So you can go from here to there. And it's like forward and back. With a lot of the other manufacturers, I'm trying not to name names here because I don't really want to get in trouble with any of them. But you lean like this a lot. And it's like you're trying to do stormsy, like, yeah, man's not hot and stuff. But ideally, you'd have your elbow here in a nice position. Maybe that's a tiny bit high. Just there, tiny bit more up. Perfect, perfect. Instantaneous, stupendous contraption. It's perfect. So again, I'm just picking out the things that for me make this car something that I'd happily own. Gadgets wise, you've got your lane assist, you've got your active cruise control. It is something you'd want to show off at, but I believe after about 10-15 seconds it does remind you and say, hey, you better control this car, my friend, if not we're gonna just let you crash. So it goes from green to saying, hey, like, we're gonna help you, to yellow, like, wake up, stop watching Netflix, to red, are you ready to use your gap insurance? So for me, the gadgets, I don't know, sometimes too much gadgets isn't a good thing, because that means there's more to go wrong. But in my opinion, it's got enough, just enough, what it needs. So lane assist, active cruise control, I think that could be it. Because with some of these cars, when something goes wrong, it could potentially withdraw the power off the car, and then that's like, oh, go to your local service station and get it fixed and all of that. We don't like that. We don't like none of that malarkey. So the boot space in this is crazy good. Luckily, my sister, who's just moved to a new place, love your sis, she's asked me to do some IKEA shopping for her. And previously, the car I drive, the coupe that I drive, it was quite a push to get it to fit, but the boot space in this is crazy. So it's nice to know, if you do have a hatchback, you want to take the family out for a picnic, it's good to know you've got ample boot space to get just about two suitcases, I'd say, in, or some IKEA furniture in, without any problems. Not that I'd sit there at any point in the ownership of my car, but rear space is decent. I know a lot of these hatchbacks tend to favour more of the driver and giving them a nice space and whatnot, but rear, there's no slope in rear end, so you're getting a lot of headroom. It's not claustrophobic. I hate this word, so I'm just going to say you don't feel very squeezed in the back, because it's not claustrophobic. You don't feel squeezed in, so it's a good thing. It's a very, very good thing, and it's a very good design how they've done it. So rear space in this, perfect. And while we touched on the crystal clearness off this center console and the LCD screen, the virtual cockpit Audi, if I could bow down without taking my eyes off the road, I would, because, mate, the interior, the crystal clearness is perfect. You can go from one view to another, flick through it. It's up to you. I like to have mine with the speedos full bang, so they're not the smaller version. And I just like knowing the consumption, just so I can kind of rein myself in when I try and boot it around town, especially because for some reason there is a petrol shortage. No, there's not. Last but not least, something that I always crave, and I know, this isn't a full fat RS model, but the individual mode on any car is important, because some people don't want the crashy suspension or the heavy steering feel. This has got an individual mode which allows you to set every single parameter that you want the way you want it. So there you have it. Those are the things that I like and dislike about the car. Thanks as usual to Audi UK Press for supplying the car. I hope you're all well. I hope you're having a great Sunday, and I'll see you in the next one. God bless.